Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video we are going to discuss how to score more marks in FCI 2019. Within 4 to 5 days this FCI 2019 exam is going to begin. So now let's see what are the major concepts and what are the important concepts where you need to concentrate more, and how to solve the concepts easily. Okay, so let's begin our video. First, coming to English, you will be given 30 questions where you will be having only 20 minutes to solve those 30 questions. That is, you are not even getting 1 minute per question. So you need to increase your time of solving a particular question. So if you get stuck at one question, just leave it and move forward to another question, because every single question and every single mark matters a lot in FCI exam, because there is a lot of competition coming to this exam. So now let's see, coming to English, you'll be having fill in the blanks, spotting the error, parasymbols, and reading comprehension. So coming to reading comprehension, the questions from reading comprehension will take more time compared to any other questions from English. Okay, so coming to English, reading comprehension, you will be having the passages like which will contain the passages of more than 10 to 12 lines, and you have very limited period of time and very lengthy questions. So what to do, how to solve reading comprehension questions within less than a minute? What you need to do is, first start reading the question. Okay, so coming to reading comprehension, you'll be having questions. First read that question and try to understand what is the question about and what is the answer expected from the question. So now what you need to do is, as you know what is the question and what is the answer for, like what is the answer expected to that question, start searching the question related sentence from the whole paragraph. Okay, so when you know the question already, your mind will be more alert in searching answer for that question. So you can easily find the solution within less than 30 seconds. So trust me, follow this technique, it really helps. So instead of reading the passage first and then question, follow this technique of reading the question first and then going to the passage, so that it really helps and you can find the answer very easily. Trust me. And coming to fill in the blanks, the most of the people will feel fill in the blanks is the toughest section, because the options will be really confusing. So use one technique to solve the fill in the blanks. What you need to do is, when you are feeling more than one answer as correct, so when you are feeling like when you are confused with the answer, then try elimination method. For example, I have 4 options out of which I'm sure that two of the options are wrong, and another 2 options I am confused, like whether option A or option B. Then what I need to do is just try elimination method. Okay, use logical brain and logical thinking. Okay, so don't panic, use logical thinking. If you feel like 50-50% chances of option A and option B, but after thinking twice, you're feeling option A has 60% criteria, like 60% weightage of being correct answer, then just go for it. Okay, don't waste time in thinking more and more time, because you'll be having 30 questions whereas only 20 minutes time. So you have to hurry up in solving the questions. You can't waste your time. Time management is one of the most important thing which matters in FCI exam, and not only FCI exam, in any competitive exam. Okay, every single mark matters in this kind of exams. Okay, so coming to spotting the errors, one of the best technique I wanted to tell is spotting the errors. So most of the students or most of the aspirants of FCI, like any competitive exam, will think that coming to spotting the errors, you'll be like really confused. You'll feel like, sometimes you may feel that there is no error only, and sometimes what happens is you'll think 4 to 5 errors you may find out, but you will not know what is the one single error which is correct. Okay, so in this such cases, so when you feel that there is no error, make sure only 2 to 3% of chances will be where the answer no errors will be correct. Okay, so most of the time errors will be there. Okay, they'll not give you the correct sentence and they'll not be like just waste your time, think of it, because there's no answer for it, there's no error for it. This kind of situations will not be there most of the times. 99% of the times in any competitive exams, coming to spotting the errors, you will be having errors in the particular sentence. Okay, so what you need to do is, instead of trying for finding the errors, remember this technique. In this technique, what I wanted to tell is, and, or, the, such kind of words most of the time in the sentences will be missing, or the small grammar things like and, have been, had been, have gone, or you know, did, the, or, such kind of words will be missing, that will be the error in that particular sentence. So make sure what is missing or what is added additionally. Okay, if you just find out this small logic, you can easily spot the error within seconds. Okay, so coming to reasoning ability, alphanumeric series. Okay, so coming to alphanumeric series, what you need to do is practice more and more questions, refer to previous papers, give mock tests daily, so that it really helps for you. Because coming to series, it's not that there's no technique for alphanumeric series, because each and every concept, each and every question in series will be completely different. So make sure you concentrate more on practicing series. Okay, because most of the students will be losing marks coming to series. And coming to blood relations, what happens is,